Greetings. I'm Father Pieter vanRooyen from St. Joseph Parish in Ypsilanti and Sacred Heart Major Seminary in Detroit. Thanks for joining me as we make our way together through Bishop Boyer's Year of the Bible. Today we consider Genesis chapter 19. In some ways, this is part of the PG-13 section of the Bible. We never hear this chapter at Sunday Mass, and as you read it, you might see why. But even if it's graphic and challenging, it's still the Word of God, and it still shows us important truths about sin and our need for a Savior. It starts with the sin of Sodom and Gomorrah. In chapter 18 of Genesis, Abraham had bargained with God to spare the city from judgment if only 10 good men would be found there. But when God's angels arrive at Sodom, they find a city full of sin. In fact, the men in the city try to rape God's messengers, his angels, who were staying at Lot's home. And Lot tries to ply them with his own daughters. And Ezekiel 16 lists other sins of Sodom. The people of Sodom were also full of pride and gluttony and greed, and they neglected the poor. So God allows his judgment to fall on Sodom and Gomorrah. What do we make of all this? What do we make of all this sin and judgment? Where is the good news here? Well, first of all, we need to keep in mind that the God of the Old Testament is the same as the God of the New Testament. The same God who allows judgment to come upon Sodom and Gomorrah is the very same God who became man and died for every single human being. God desires all men to be saved. God is love. So what does judgment mean? Well, it shows that God doesn't just ignore sin. Sin causes a disorder in the universe that cries out for justice. All creation is meant to worship and love God, and loving God, we're meant to love and care for our neighbor. But sin causes disorder and throws the world off kilter. Sin causes death and violence and destruction, which cry out to be set right. We see this when we see innocent children suffering violence or racism or hatred. We cry out to God. We say, God, come set the world right. Don't let this sin go unpunished. And here God allows partial justice to come to Sodom and Gomorrah. He allows them to experience some of the effects of their sin, but he does it because he loves them. Ultimate justice will only come through our Lord Jesus. When God gives himself to death on the cross, this is where the ultimate justice comes. Only through Jesus' sacrifice, through his blood shed, and through the loving obedience through which he gave his life on the cross, does he ultimately undo sin and violence and set the world right. The same God who didn't find 10 righteous men in Sodom and who allowed punishment to fall on the cities of Sodom and Gomorrah, he desires their salvation and ours more than we can imagine. Ultimately, he gave himself up to destruction on the cross to undo their disobedience and yours and mine and to pierce the hardness of our hearts. So as you read about the sin and judgment in Genesis 19 and through the rest of the Old Testament, consider God's ultimate answer to our injustice in our Lord Jesus Christ and pray with me, come Lord Jesus, have mercy on us sinners. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, you are the first and primary author of sacred scripture. Help me to receive what you have revealed in your holy word. Give me a greater hunger to daily seek you in the scriptures so that I might come to know you and your Son more intimately. May your Holy Spirit open me to be transformed by your holy word throughout this year of the Bible. We ask these blessings through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.